Hello there, welcome into the channel. This is Sage, Sunset of Sage, Sunset Healing Tarot. Thank you for being here. I'm Cancer and welcome in. Much love. These are going to be general messages for the sign of Cancer. So because they're general messages, all of the messages may not apply to all of you. So take the ones that apply to you and the rest let them fly. Thank you so much for hitting the like button, for sharing and subscribing to the channel. All of your support means so much. Thank you so much for the wonderful donations. Much appreciated. I had a wonderful surprise yesterday, especially after doing that money reading yesterday. If you haven't checked out that reading yet, do go do that. It's incredible. I feel like I literally manifested that donation. It was so beautiful. I'm so grateful. So thank you for that donation I received yesterday. So I feel like I'm about to do a love reading for you. I feel like there's going to be a union with a sun sign, or I mean a Leo vibration with the sun energy that I saw earlier. And now I'm seeing the lovers and the union vibration again. So this could be soulmate. And I just wanted to say, I feel you may be having a child or children with this person, or some eggs or something fertile. Something fertile, you know. Our energies. Welcome into the channel. This is Sage, Sunset Healing Tarot. Thank you for being here, Cancerian. Much love to you. These are going to be general tarot card messages for the sign of Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. So welcome in. I hope to get accurate messages for you. These are general messages, so they all may not apply to all of you. So take what applies for you and the rest let them fly. So welcome in. Thank you for hitting that like button, for sharing the messages, and for subscribing to the channel. That's a way of showing your support, and I really do appreciate that. So, love messages for you for today. Empress vibration, you sit in here. Someone may come around to you. Maybe they may come around to your house, but now I'm feeling that this person may come to your thoughts, in your mind space. But initially, I was feeling like this person is going to come around to your house. So this person could be a fire sign, or this person could be a fellow water sign. Water, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, fire, Aries, Leo, or a Sagi. I'm also feeling Taurus vibration. This person want to come around with some message of something or another to you, something in your emotional space, a good message too. It's going to make you feel good. I feel like you're going to be thinking hard on this message using your discernment, like the Four of Cups energy here. Let me think about this. What are you coming with? Of course, you know, I feel like you're kind of in defense, or you're using your intuition as the High Priestess. Instead of saying you're in defense, you're just really using your discernment, which is good for you. So let's not talk about defense as if, you know. This person could also be an earth sign who is at work, and this person may be thinking of you to come to you, talk some truth to you, give you some higher knowledge or some love. I don't know, because the Ace of Swords is also love. As much as it is forceful, or it can be blunt and sharp, or it can just be a great amount of information. So this person could be sharing some valuable information with you about work, okay? They also may be just coming to you with some truth, and you are kind of having a foresight of this with the High Priestess showing up here. Your intuition is telling you who this is. So let me tell you, this person is at work, is working, works with their hand, has their own platform, and they have this sword, which feels like a thought that's on their mind. It's like they have something to give you. They're considering coming, or they have already made up their mind to come and talk to you. Like, this is already yours to hear. Oh my gosh. This may be coming to you today. I feel like you're going to actually hear this person's voice some way, shape, or form today. Okay. Or receive a message. They want to give you something, maybe a surprise, a gift. It could feel like a gift, I'm not sure, with the Ten of Pentacles. A surprise. It's something that they hope will make you feel good. But look at you. You represent here with the Two of Cups. High Priestess, similar vibration. So it's in receiving this or meeting this person, you already know what's going on. High Priestess, you know, this is how you stand here, aware. In this moment, you're looking and feeling at this gift or this person. So right now, you're using your discernment. How should I receive this? Or should I? But this person is waiting for your response. Because it is something that I feel when you open it and see it, it's supposed to make you happy or not happy, but the Ten of Pentacles energy, which feels like new beginnings of wealth, new money coming into you. It's supposed to make you feel good. That's their hope. Okay, so it's supposed to, it could be money or material things, but it's supposed to get into your heart, into your emotions. It's like this person wants to directly, see how much offering, like offering here. Thrice. All around you. Okay, so like it's like they could be coming by, they could be visiting you, sending you a message. Or sending a message to your family. So you could be hearing from this person in multiple ways. Sending you an email. And then you're hearing from them over here as well. Or it's like everywhere you go, you see this person turning up. So what is the Ten of Pentacles? Something about this red building. Maybe they're going to show you something. You know. Maybe they're going to show you something red. That's why we're talking about using your discernment here, because what is this that they want to offer to you? It feels like a seal. Could be marriage. You know? Could be a proposal. A business. No, love. Like a seal. It's like they open a box to show you something. And there's a red seal with the wax. With that wax energy. And they're smiling in your face. No, they're looking up at you and smiling. But you are not smiling. You're wondering, what is this? What's going on here? And this person sort of expects you to feel good. It's like they're promising you or they're proposing something to you with conditions attached. You know, the seal vibration. I feel like you may hand this back to this person, whatever it is. Or I feel you're going to use your higher intuition about the situation. You're going to think about it. It may bring up some past feelings for you that you're going to have to be fabulous about, really. When I say that, I mean stand in your power. Flex your power, your flexibility in mind, in knowing who you are. So, like, miss me with that past thought that wants to come back. You're not coming back the same. I'm not the same person. Like, excuse me, with the Gone with the Wind fabulous energy of Page of Swords. Something ended in the past. Something is old. And I hear gravelicious or grabalicious. It's a term we use for someone that's greedy and wants to just have their cake and eat it too. You know, they don't just want a slice of the pie. They want to eat the whole thing and then some. Cases like this person has been really thinking. All of what I'm saying feels like some thoughts that's been going on in this person's mind, even as they work to come around to you and do all of these things. So maybe just be careful, beware of that. And dreamer. Okay, just so you know, the Judgment card is here, so I feel it will be obvious. You know, it will be obvious and it will allow you to make a better decision for yourself. because this offer that this person is coming with, it looks pretty with the Ten of Pentacles, you know. But there's just something beneath it. I can't really see what it is right now in these cards, honestly. But it's like this person has a little smile on their face. I'm not sure if it is a smile of hopefulness, of hopeful expectation of making you happy, but it just feels a little bit more than that. Especially in the seal. It feels like maybe the intention. But it's not just that. You know, as if they could want to hurt you by giving you some information that you probably don't even care about, but they want to tell you anyway. So, no, that just don't resonate. A seal. I'm going to leave this because I can't. It's like there's something in a box. Something's on top of it. And it's pushed on, and you see it as you open the box. But what they want to give to you is the Ten of Pentacles. Feels like a surprise. It looks blingy. It looks beautiful. But you are deeper than that. You're not looking at the external or the superficial beauty. You're thinking of the intention in the proposal or the gift. So you're like, okay, beautiful, but what's this about? Okay. And I feel like this is when things get real. And I just don't know what happens after this. Because you see in the Five of Cups, red is spilt. So what was standing is now spilt, is lost. Red represents what? Roots, identity, I don't know, knowledge, blood, sacred stuff. I don't know. Like maybe you, I don't, because it doesn't, my energy don't want to get gruesome. But my mind is exploring if it could be a gift that has some kind of, what the fuck is this red building? Anyone else watches my channel that does tarot? And want to explain this red building to me in the Ten of Pentacles Rider-Waite tarot deck. Like, what do you feel when you look at that erection behind? Is it? But I can't tell you. I feel like if I only knew something about an old-time religion or something, I would understand what is going on here. You know? I'm busting up my brain. Maybe that has something to do with it. I can see it, you know, but I can't say it. I don't know it. You know what I mean? I can see it, but I don't know it. I can see it. Like it's a matrix building here. You know, like walking in the matrix, but and you know that something is off with this building. It's not really there. So something stands out that it's different. But I just can't tell you why it's different. It's because I don't know why it's different. So the same building is here in the Five of Cups, but it's not red. It feels like the same building. Maybe it's just the same type of art.
But it's been spilled out of the building now. It's red and it's left yellow. You know what I mean? You don't know what I mean because I don't know what I mean. So it may have something to do with a house. May have something to do with a house that really resonates. What is it? It feels like something of old. It feels like a house over a fence. And there's a story behind this house, but no one really understands it. Like the people that live over there. But it's something about this house or the building behind this. It may have to do with the people that live in the house. Like, you know, it's the energy of people that live in this mysterious house. No one really sees them or knows their story. I'm not saying they're evil or bad or anything, really. It's just that this house is in the middle of this place and there's a wall. A fencing it's over there. It feels like I've been here before, but it's so far away. Or I'm telling myself it's far away. Why am I doing that? If it is right here. Because I'm right here. So I know this now. Okay. So maybe this is all it is. Maybe this gift that you're getting is about. It's going to make you know something now. You know? Like they're going to give you something and it's going to maybe validate or prove or assure something. Like I know this now. Okay. That's how I feel. That's the most resonating energy I can find with this gift. But it's like being in a dream or literally being in the matrix and seeing something. And knowing it now, like presently, no, today, no, like this is supposed to be telling me about something, no, but me, no, I don't know. It could be a gift of a house or about a house around a fence, behind a fence, but there's something about what is over there. Like the story, these people feel different. You know, like an Asian family moving to Jamaica and they like fence up the yard. No one can really tell what's going on over there. Not that they're bad people or anything. It's just that they live it. They're in the midst of this, in this place. Everyone knows that it's the Asians that live over there. But it's the idea of the energy of not really knowing much about these people. But we walk past this wall every day. What am I talking about? It's almost like I can something about being over there and knowing, or I can be one of the people that know about this house. But I can also be aware. I don't know the fuck. It's something about being aware. No, you know this now. Whatever the gift that they're giving to you, whenever you see this red thing on it, red thing or whatever this called is, I don't know, it's almost like it's gonna make you know now. It's like you're being aware now. It's like being in the matrix and receiving this gift, and then you look up at the same building that something you've always felt like something is off with this building or this money, or because the pentacles is money and energy, and we see a lot of it's a lot of gains and prosperity, something like that. But it's getting this awareness within, being aware in matrix, and then looking at that same building and say, oh, I know now. You know, because you've always felt like something was off, maybe pertaining to your house or your money or your prosperity. And this gift that you're getting, it's like, oh, I know now about what. Now you're looking, almost like looking in the box at the red seal, this gift. And then you're looking up at the building or the whatever is to, was perplexing you. And then going, oh, I know now. I don't know why that was standing out. I don't know why that was happening so. I don't know who these people. I know now who these people are that's living over this yard. I understand now why they stay away from others. Yes, 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 I like that. Like, I understand who these people are now, why they built the fence. Something like that. You know, I know now. And it's all because of a message that you're receiving with a red seal on it. It could be a check that you're getting too, really. Some payments. But it's not just bringing money, it's bringing awareness. It's like getting a check from, like, a government check of something. Or something like that. But it's bringing an awareness to you. And this is supposed to be a love reading. So it could be coming from love, maybe family, friends, or a person in your past that loved you. All right. So you may be getting a message or an envelope like this person is working on it to put it together. You see that? Okay. And then the judgment is here with the red energy and the flag as well. Judgment. Casting judgment. And being self-aware. Alright, so that's what's happening for you today, Cancer. Let me know how this goes for you. If you get this dawning or this awareness. Alright, I'll see you in the next one. Thank you so much for coming through. If you find any of the messages here resonating with you, do leave a like on the video. Share the messages with those you love. Hit share to your WhatsApp, Facebook group, blog post if you're a writer. Because I know many Cancers are artists. And you express yourself in writing. That's why I bring up the blog. So if the messages inspire you, share them, please. And also subscribe if you have not yet done so. Much love to you. And I'll see you in the next one. Remember that you are all and all is within you, my darling. Take care. Bye.